In Grand Readings, 2024, and I start the year in a different light than I expected. This video is out of schedule, in the sense that it was not in my plans, but it's important enough, and I want to shoot it non-incrementally. So you can just listen to this video. So if you remember, I said, oh, well, I just use a subset of the features, and being proficient in SuperMemo doesn't mean you use all of the features, right? So following that is weird. Some people just don't use a subset of features. They just completely move on. They stop using SuperMemo at all. Which this is not news. This have happened since day one because SuperMemo has a tremendous amount of friction points you have to tolerate. So what's happening now? That more users are moving on SuperMemo. It's more frequent, even especially the long-term SuperMemo users, 3, 5 years or whatever, that they have invested a ton of time to build their knowledge, their collection, and so on. What made the difference? FSRS. In case you don't know, it's free space repetition software or system. That basically, it's an open source algorithm that tries to mimic SuperMemo's algorithm with the three components. Long-term memory components, difficulty, stability, and reliability. With some heuristics, because there's a lot of missing information, because in Anki, you only have the flashcard, the final product of the learning process. The learning process, it's not there. But hey, wait a second. There is people who actually use SuperMemo like this. They do the reading elsewhere. Kindle, whatever that may be. Then they export the flashcards, so they only have items. So, if I only have items in SuperMemo, so I'm skipping all of the incremental reading features, and I have Anki, what was the difference? The performance, the scheduling algorithm, that in SuperMemo you could have the same retention rate doing a lot less repetitions. And when I mean a lot less, in my usage, was like a quarter. And even with a higher retention rate than in Anki. So timing is really key. But that's not the point of this video. The point is that what I call the FSRS wave. Now, makes sense to move on from SuperMemo to Anki, because the difference, yeah, you will have an algorithm that performs more or less the same for short term, for short intervals, and then for long intervals, there's still elucidation needed. And real usage with long-term, long intervals. For now, the long intervals are from cards that existed already. So they use a different algorithm before and so on. So it's not the same thing. So it's not to surprise that more people are moving on if they haven't used incremental reading or they stop using incremental reading. I would have done the same. And spoiler alert, I did. For language learning. I'm still using SuperMemo, obviously, for incremental reading. But if I was not using incremental reading, I would not use SuperMemo, because everything else, all of the language learning, is in Anki. I have one video, will be one corner, how I converted my advanced English collection to Anki, using some heuristics of the missing data, and what is not one-on-one transfer. That was just an experiment. But turns out, long-term, that, oops, I'm not doing English. Well, I'm doing some sort of English in my incremental reading collection. The names of theories, authors, and so on, which appeared there of what I'm reading. But for the sake of grammar, spelling, pronunciation, and so on, I have a dedicated collection for English. That, if I'm honest, in 2023, I think I opened like just to add information, not to review information. Yes, most of the items were in the multi-year interval already, so that could wait. But wait, I had a copy in Anki as well, where all cards are mature already in the 2 years, year and a half intervals already. But you know what? Now I have FSRS. Let me actually try it out. Well, the results are not as good as a new collection, because the intervals are already set at 1 year and so on. So the scheduling algorithm doesn't adapt to my performance because a couple of million repetitions have happened already with a different algorithm. So yeah, I get this, but skipping all the details, it's good enough. But even before that, even before FSRS, even using the default scheduling, I still used Anki for language learning. Why? Because the cards were not new, were in multi-years. So if I, usually the performance is worse at the beginning, right? The first intervals. I skipped all of this. But for now that I can do all of the new cards as well, with all the convenience that Anki offers, which, by the way, I don't use Anki on the phone. I don't use Anki Web to sing because I'm way above the threshold. Even though for me it's enough to have full support of modern standards, that I'm not going back to SuperMemo for that. There's no chance. No chance. Even if SuperMemo releases a new algorithm with machine learning and whatever, I don't care an improvement in my retention rate. It's not worth it. The price I have to pay. That Windows only, the audio registry super cheap solution with templates and so on. So it makes total sense that people are moving on SuperMemo because of FSRS. I know people who used SuperMemo and quite long term, more than a decade, who actually doesn't use incremental reading at all. So I would like to see what happens, what these people do in the long term. Yeah, I get that some people like that, actually they never used Anki because they predate Anki. They started using SuperMemo before Anki existed. So if they have never used Anki, I can understand they just keep what they are familiar with. But for people who use both, or first Anki, then SuperMemo, they know Anki really well. It's a no-brainer. It's a no-brainer. I will do the same. I have done the same at some extent. Feel free to speak your mind. And if you want to share, you have also moved on SuperMemo. And let's see what the feature unfolds for SuperMemo. Because every time I see less and less light into the feature. I don't want to be pessimistic. But, I don't know. Nothing more to add today. And see you incrementally.